India is the second largest producer of silk and also the largest consumer of silk in the world next to China. The other major producing countries are Japan, Korea, Thailand, Vietnam, Uzbekistan, and Brazil. United States is by far the largest importer of silk products today. India has a strong tradition and culture bound to the domestic market of silk. In India, mulberry silk is produced mainly in the states of Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Jammu and Kashmir, Orissa, and North and West Bengal. While the non-mulberry silks are produced in Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh is the eastern states. Silk is a high value but low volume product accounting for only 0.2% of world's total textile production. Silk production is regarded as an important tool for economic development of a country as it is a labor intensive and high income generating industry that churns out value added products of economic importance. The developing countries rely on it for employment generation, especially in rural sector and also as a means to earn the foreign exchange. There are five major types of silks of commercial importance obtained from different species of silkworms, which in turn feed on a number of food plants. These are mulberry silkworm, the Bombyx mori, Tassar silkworm, Antheria mylita, Muga silkworm, Antheria asama, Eri silkworm, Phylosomia racinae. Except mulberry, other non-mulberry varieties of silks are generally termed as vanya silks. India has the unique distinction of producing all these commercial varieties of silks. The natural silk is synthesized by the silkworm and spun in the form of cocoon is originally synthesized in the silk line. Silk line of Bombyx mori is a typical exocrine gland secreting large amount of silk proteins. It is a paired organ consisting of modified labial salivary glands located at the two lateral sides under the alimentary canal. Each gland is basically a tube made of glandular epithelium with two rows of cells surrounding the lumen. The cells constituting the gland are huge polyploid cells, each with extremely ramified nucleus containing numerous nucleoli. Nuclear ramification develops gradually as the larvae grows and reaches conspicuous size in the fourth and fifth instars. Ramification considerably enlarges the nuclear surface and apparently facilitates the transfer of materials related to the silk synthesis between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. According to its morphology and function, the silk gland can be divided into three distinct regions, the anterior, middle, and posterior regions. The posterior region is about 15 centimeters long and is composed of about 500 secretory cells which synthesize silk fibrin. The middle silk gland, in the lumen of which silk proteins are stored until spinning, is about 7 centimeters long and contains about 300 secretory cells producing silk sericin, the protein which cements the fibrin thread of the cocoon. The anterior part, about 2 centimeters long, is a thin duct composed of about 250 cells with no known secretory function. The Bombyx Morris silk gland secretes one fibroin and three layers of sericin from each posterior and middle regions of the silk gland. Composition of the silk filament. Sericin is chemically a non-filamentous protein. Besides sericin, raw silk also contains other constituents like fat and waxes, inorganic salts and coloring matter. Composition of silk in Bombyx mori, according to Gul Rajani 1988. The composition of silk is as follows. Fibroin constitutes 70 to 80%, sericin 20 to 30%, wax matter 0.4 to 0.8%, carbohydrates 1.2 to 1.6%, inorganic matter 0.7%, pigment 0.2%, comprising a whole 100% of silk fiber. Sericin is insoluble in cold water, however, it is easily hydrolyzed, whereby long protein molecules breaks down into smaller fractions which are easily dispersed or solubilized in hot water. The composition of amino acid varies in different layers of sericin. Sericin protein is useful because of its special properties like resists oxidation, antibacterial, UV resistant, and absorbs and releases moisture easily, inhibitory activity of tyrosine and kinase, etc. Sericin, a major component of silk fiber, has been selectively removed from fibroin by decumming during the silk manufacturing process to make silk lustrous. The fibroin made up of two brins. The fibroin is thin, long, light and soft. It is well known for its water absorbency, dyeing affinity, thermotolerances, insulation properties and luster. It is the raw material for producing precious royal textile fabrics. It is reported that ionic liquid could hold the key to the production of designer silk fabrics with enhanced mechanical and optical properties. The silk fiber have outstanding natural properties which rival the most advanced synthetic polymers. Yet, unlike the synthetic polymers, the production of silk does not require harsh processing conditions. It is reported that the introduction of ionic liquids to silk processing opens an exciting avenue for controlling the microstructure to tune the microscopic properties. The amino acid compositions of silk fibroin residues per 1000 residues. For every 1000 residues, glycine constitutes 446, alanine 294, valine 22, leucine 5.3, isoleucine 6.6, sericin 121, threonine 9.1, aspartic acid 13.0, glutamic acid 10.2, lysine 3.2, arginine 4.7, histidine 1.4, tyrosine 51.7, phenylalanine 6.3, proline 3.6, tryptophan 1.1, methionine 1 and cysteine 2, it is 2. Silk is commonly considered to be the queen of all fabrics, aesthetics. Cultivated silk is a beautiful, luxurious fiber with a smooth, luxurious hand. This type of silk can be dyed and printed on bright colors that are very pleasing to the eye. While silks are duller and have a more coarse hand and texture, silk abrasion resistance is moderate. However, it is ranked high in strength for natural fibers. Silk fabrics have good absorbency. Fabrics made from silk are comfortable in the summer and warm in the winter. Silk fabrics have only moderate resistance to wrinkling. Silk fiber is quite soft and sometimes it feels crispy. The clothes or apparels that are made from silk are luxurious and simply expensive. Silk is widely used in Bangladesh and India to make the traditional silk sari that is worn in any kind of festivals or social programs. Silk fiber is flexible and possesses excellent draping property. This facilitates silk garment making very easy and comfortable. It gives a gorgeous appearance upon wearing. Silk is the finest among all natural fibers, as it is so much thinner fiber. So silk can be used or easily blended on any kind of fabric or clothes to be made. The dyeing property of silk is good. It has affinity for the wide range of dyes and shows excellent to moderate dye fastness properties. Due to the fiber's flexibility and other convenience, the silk fabric can easily be printed without any problem. The washing fastness of silk fiber is good. One can wash the silk fabric by water and its luster can be rejuvenated by treating with vinegar or dilute acetic acid in the last wash. The main problem of silk fabric is that silk creates static charge during wear or using any other purposes. This can be dissipated by dampening the silk. Silk fabric has no piling problem. The fabrics can be stacked for long time without any damage. Silk fabric possesses good resistance to abrasion and manufacturing forces. Light fastness property for silk is poor. The main disadvantage of silk fiber upon prolonged exposure to the sun, silk deteriorates and loses its luster. The shimmering appearance for which silk is prized comes from the fiber's triangular prism-like structure, which allows silk cloth to refract incoming light at different angles. Silk fibers are very fine, about 10 nanometers, that is 1 by 2500th of an inch in diameter. Silk fiber is as strong as steel in tensile strength. Silk is the strongest natural fiber. It has a tenacity of 3.5 to 4 grams per denier and an elongation of 10% to 12%. Uses of silk in textiles. Silk fibers are a masterpiece of nature whose remarkable properties have yet to be fully explored. Silk is designated as queen of textiles because no other fabric has facilitated the people so continuously over millennia as silk. Silk is mainly woven on about 2,30,000 handlooms in households, and about 30,000 power looms are engaged in silk weaving sectors in India. Silk fiber is widely used to make different items. In apparel, silk industry is used for making dresses, blouses, skirts, jackets, pants, scarves, and ties. Silk is highly versatile fabric. Silk has proven to be ideal for variety of uses, from formal wear to sleepwear, from parachute to rugs, from medical sutures to prosthetic arteries. Silk-based materials have been transformed in just the past decade from the commodity textile world to a growing web of applications in a more high technology directions. Silkworm is being used as a biofactory for the production of useful protein. Silk proteins are natural polymers and are biodegradable, and with reactive functional groups that are open up possibly to be cross-linked with other polymers to be used in controlled delivery. Like other common biomedical textiles such as polyester, silk contains various polar functional groups that might enhance antibiotic absorption. Biodegradable materials. Environment friendly biodegradable polymers can be produced by blending sericin with other resins. The polyurethane foams incorporating sericin are said to have excellent moisture absorbing and desorbing properties. Polymer films, foams, molding resins, and fiber containing sericin can be produced by reacting a composition comprising a polyol, toluene, diisocyanate, dibutylidene, dilauriate, and dichloromonofluoromethane, a blowing agent, in the presence of sericin. The moisture absorption desorption rate of sericin containing the polyurethane form is 2-fold to 5-fold greater. It has also been reported that sericin containing polyurethane exhibit excellent mechanical and thermal properties. Membrane materials. Membrane-brain separations like reverse osmosis, dialysis, ultrafiltration, and microfiltration are used in processes such as desalination of water, production of extremely pure water, the bioprocessing industry, and some chemical processes. Sericin and fibroin can be used to make membranes for use in separation processes. The insolubilized silk fibroin membrane could be used to separate the mixture of water and alcohol. Functional biomaterials. Sericin film located on lay of liquid crystal can uniformly orient the liquid crystal molecules to provide distortion-free, high-quality crystal displays. Sericin-coated film is used on the surface of refrigeration equipment because of its anti-frosting action. Use of the coated sericin film is an effective anti-frosting method that can be widely applied to refrigerator, deep freezers and refrigerated trucks and ships. Moreover, use of the coated film on roads and roofs can prevent frost damage to snowfall regions. Sericin protein can be coated on surfaces of various durable materials to enhance functionality. Sericin can be used in the preparation of art pigments and for surface protection of particles. Medical biomaterials. Silkworm silk fibers have been the primary silk-like materials used in biomedical applications, particularly as sutures. During decades of use, silk fibers have proven to be effective in many clinical applications. Silk fibroin-based wound dressing that could accelerate healing and could be peeled off without damaging the newly formed skin. Film made of sericin and fibroin has excellent oxygen permeability and is similar to human cornea and its functional properties. A novel muco-adhesive polymer has been prepared by template polymerization of acrylic acid in the presence of silk sericin. Silk protein can be made into a biomaterial with anticoagulant properties by sulfonation treatment of sericin and fibroin, provided the first evidence of antioxidant action of the silk protein by showing that sericin suppressed in vitro lipid peroxidation. Furthermore, sericin also found to inhibit tyrosinase activity. These results suggested that sericin is a valuable natural ingredient for food and cosmetics. Sericin gel is prepared by using sericin solution with pluronic and carbopol as a stabilizer to prevent water loss from the upper layers of the skin. It forms a moisturizing, semi-occlusive, protective, anti-wrinkle film on the skin surface, imparting an immediate, long-lasting, smooth, silky feeling. Fibroin in cosmetics. Fibroin has been explored as a biomedicine for various applications. Fibroin powder was processed in such a way to retain its natural optical beauty. The unique property of the silk powder is its ability to hold and release moisture depending on the temperature and humidity of the surroundings. The extremely fine powder, 11.3 micron size, is particularly ideal for applications in pressed powders, blushes, eye makeup, lipstick and nail enamel. Sericin and fibroin have been recently explored in the field of drug delivery systems. Silk woven into transistors. Research in Sweden and Spain have created transistors woven from modified silk fibers. The latest breakthrough bodes well for a new generation of electronic circuits that can be incorporated into fabrics or inserted into biological environments.